Major funding for the production of Granite State Challenge has been provided by Unitil, Energy for Life. NEA New Hampshire, shaping the future one student at a time. With additional funding from Heinemann Publishing, D.F. Richard, Markham Image, Pax World Funds, and from viewers like you. Thank you.
For 30 years, New Hampshire high school students have been matching wits in a high-stakes scholastic showdown. Get ready to take the Granite State Challenge. And here's your host, Jim Janot.
And hi again, everybody. We welcome you once again to another game of Granite State Challenge. Tonight is our fourth and final quarterfinal round game. Three schools have already won quarterfinals to move into our semifinals. They include Portsmouth Christian Academy, Bishop Girton High School, and Pinkerton Academy. The winner of tonight's game will join them in our Final Four coming up in the next couple of weeks. So let's introduce you to the two teams playing in tonight's quarterfinal game. First of all, we have the team from Keene High School. With an enrollment of just over 1,500 students, Keene is located in Cheshire County.
Hi, I'm Adam. I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Emrys. I'm a sophomore.
Hi, I'm Oscar. I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Carl. I'm a senior.
The team is coached by Susan Romano, and the alternates are Diego Betancourt and Nikhil Bomati. And they are the Blackbirds of Keene High School. So there you have the Blackbirds. Now let's introduce you to their opponents for tonight's quarterfinal. This is the team from Plymouth High School. With an enrollment of just about 690 students, Plymouth High School, located in Grafton County.
Hi, I'm Sophie, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Andrew, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Alexander, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Nathan, and I'm a sophomore.
With us for the program, the coach for the team, Jay Fogarty, and the alternates are Sean Harris and Jot Sandhu, the Bobcats of the Plymouth High School. Our last introduction is to let you know who our judges are. Once again, we welcome back Jim Johnston and Ann Belanger. All right, here we go into round one, which is our 10-point toss-up round. We'll get on into our bonus and 60-second rounds just a little bit later on. But right now, Keene and Plymouth, 10-pointers coming your way. Here we go. In one form, this chemical element glows in the dark. Its name means, Sophia of Plymouth?
Neon.
I can repeat it for Keene. In one form, this chemical element glows in the dark. Its name means light bearer. Adam.
Phosphorus.
Phosphorus is correct. You can view this mural by Leonardo da Vinci in the refectory. Sophia of Plymouth?
The Last Supper.
The Last Supper is absolutely right. This woman was the second woman elected as governor of New Hampshire. And Nathan of Plymouth.
Jean Shaheen.
Keene. The second woman was current governor Maggie Hassan. Here we go for 10 points. He is the first African American to hold the office of U.S. Attorney General. Alexander of Plymouth.
Colin Powell.
Keene. Adam.
Black.
His name was Eric Holder. In what novel would you find Athos, Aramis, Porthos, Adam of Keene?
Three Musketeers.
Three Musketeers is right. This punk rock group's album, American Idiot. Nathan of Plymouth.
Green Day.
Green Day was turned into a Broadway musical in 2009. Paper and pencil in front of you if you think you might need it for this math. What is the percent of an increase in an item whose price is raised from $2 to $2.25? Adam of Keene.
12.5%.
12.5%, simple as that. All right, we have our first video question for you to look at, so do so by looking and listening.
I'm the host of America's Funniest Home Videos, have been since 2001. Many of the videos on the show feature this type of broad physical comedy that's been used by
Nathan of Plymouth.
Slapstick.
Slapstick, used by Shakespeare, Laurel and Hardy, and the Three Stooges. You are correct. What does a cytologist study? Adam of Keene.
Cells.
Cells is right. On March 8th through the 9th, 1862, Two ironclad warships battle to a standstill in the Battle of Hampton Roads, considered by many to be the most important naval battle of the Civil War. Name one of the two ships, Adam of Keene.
The Monitor.
The Monitor or the Merrimack. We would have accepted either one. Quickly, tell me, what is the square of the cube root of 64? Adam of Keene.
16.
16 is correct. Of the three main types of joints in the body, which one allows the greatest freedom of movement, Andrew of Plymouth?
The ball joint.
Judges? Keene? Adam?
The ball and socket.
The ball and socket is what we really needed. All right, this is what we'll call our picture question. We're going to put up a picture for you to look at, and then I'll ask the question. This author's play, Faust, is considered by many to be one of the greatest works of German literature. Sophia?
Goethe?
Say again?
Goethe?
Yes, Goethe is correct for the 10 points. This German engineer's four-stroke gasoline engine, mounted on a three-wheeled chassis, patented in 1886, is considered by most, Adam of Keene.
Diesel.
I can repeat it for Plymouth. This German engineer's four-stroke gasoline engine, mounted on a three-wheeled chassis, patented in 1886, is considered by most to be the world's first automobile. Andrew.
Cadillac.
It is Carl Benz. When Big Boy and Andre 3000 come together, they form this group, Nathan of Plymouth.
Outcast.
Outcast is correct. As you know, as we've been talking throughout the year, this is our 30th anniversary of Granite State Challenge, so we've been offering a 30-point question and celebrating those 30 years with a 1984 question. So teams, 30 points up for grabs on this question. On November 6, 1984, Ronald Reagan defeated this Democratic candidate, Adam of Keene.
Walter Mondale.
For president with 59% of the popular vote, Walter Mondale is correct. 30 points up on the board for Keene. This poet won a Pulitzer Prize for his collection of poetry, New Hampshire, a poem with notes and grace notes. Sophia of Plymouth.
Robert Frost.
Why not? Robert Frost is correct. Paper and pencil, once again, is in front of you if you need it. 20% of 15 pounds is equal to how many ounces? 20%. Andrew of Plymouth.
48.
48 is right. That is correct for the points. On October 19, 1919, Woodrow Wilson suffered a stroke that paralyzed him on his left side and kept him confined to his bed for weeks. Questions over how fit he was to serve as president during that time helped lead to passage of this constitutional amendment. Adam of Keene.
The 17th.
Plymouth. Sophia.
The 22nd.
It is a little bit higher. It's the 25th Amendment. These two chemical elements make up about 98 and Andrew of Plymouth.
Hydrogen and helium.
98 to 99% of the sun, hydrogen and helium is right. Suleiman I ruled over this empire from 1520. Sophia of Plymouth.
The Ottoman Empire.
The Ottoman is correct. In this remake of the 1936 Frank Capra movie, Adam Sandler plays a man who runs a pizza shop in New Hampshire. Sophia of Plymouth.
Caddyshack.
Keene. The name we're looking for was Mr. Deeds. All right, and there's the sound ending our round. Look at that. That's the way we like our games to be played. Well played first round with Keene High School holding on to a slim lead by a score of 100 to 90 after our first round. Heading into round two in a moment, which is our bonus round. Right now, though, as we do each week, we ask Lori Warren to join us. And right now, she does so by talking with the coach from Keene.
Well, thank you so much, Jim. Now we're here with the coach from Keene, who you guys did so well last year and just missed that golden carrot. Susan, how are you?
I'm doing very well, thank you.
And we're hoping that, you know, as we're in the quarterfinals, that the team continues. So what have you done to practice for success?
Well, the team members have obtained all kinds of questions, and they simply ask each other questions and practice with the buzzer. Okay. And we're always on the lookout for random information that seems like it might be Granite State Challenge material.
Oh, my head is stuffed full of it, even after all these years. But when do you practice at school?
The team meets every day, usually around 7 they're there. Mm-hmm.
So 7 a.m.?
7 a.m. till the beginning of the first bell, which is 7:20.
That's really, really early. So, you know, every single day before school?
every day before school.
Now, how many kids do you have that are going to be returning next year?
Well, we have three departing seniors, and that will leave four that are coming back.
That is perfect. That was really good planning on your part.
Well, actually, they're doing their own recruiting, and it's become a team that others are eyeing, and we certainly have attracted, they've attracted attention in the mornings with their early morning practices. Yeah. Everyone's interested. It's neat stuff to hear about, and it's a good way to test knowledge.
Well, and everybody finds it to be fun, right?
That's right. That's the best part.
I mean, and that's what it's all about, too. So what we'll do now is we'll find out how your team's going to end up doing. It's back over to you, Jim.
Thank you, Lori, and also to Susan for being with us for the program this evening. Right now, that team of Keene is ahead, but just by one question, 100 to 90, over Plymouth Regional after round number one. This is round number two. We will continue to ask the 10-point toss-up, but the team that gets the toss-up correctly has a chance at bonus points. Big round coming. Here we go. And we have another video question for you to look at and to listen to.
Albert Einstein so admired this English scientist that he kept a picture of him on the wall in his study.
Sophia of Plymouth.
Isaac Newton.
And we can repeat that video question, I believe, for Keene. So let's again give it a look.
Albert Einstein so admired this English scientist that he kept a picture of him on the wall in his study. He is credited with inventing the foundation for the electric engine.
That English scientist is Michael Faraday. Here we go for 10 points. The okapi is found in the rainforest in the Democratic Republic of the Congo. It looks like a cross between a zebra and a mule, but it is a member of this family. Adam of Keene.
Giraffe.
Giraffe family is correct. So let's go over to Adam and his teammates. We will have Adam talk to everybody and then choose a category from amiable anagrams. Can I be frank or shake, rattle, and roll? Amiable anagrams. Can I be frank or shake, rattle, and roll?
We'll take amiable anagrams.
Let's go with amiable anagrams. And Adam, you can talk to everybody up there, but I do take your answer for the team. 5 points apiece here. A lightweight boat pointed at both ends, a very large body of water.
Kayak.
Canoe and ocean. Oh. Remember what we're doing?
Oh,
amiable anagrams. A thin piece of metal used to attach papers. The soft, colorful, modified leaves on a flower.
And
it is staple and petals. What you do when someone is talking. What you are when you are not talking.
Listen and silent.
Listen and silent. 5 out of 15 on a tough bonus. Here we go for 10 points. Basketball player Julius Erving, who is known for turning the dunk into something much more graceful than a simple show of raw power, is commonly known by this nickname, Adam of Keene.
Dr. J.
Dr. J is right. So let's go back to Keene and see if we can find something better for them. Can I be frank? Hit the bricks is what's been added, and in the middle, shake, rattle, and roll. Can I be frank? Shake, rattle, and roll. Hit the bricks.
Frank. Yeah. Can I be frank?
Yes, you can. Here we go. Put 5 points apiece. Identify the following Franks. He designed the Zimmerman House in Manchester.
Frank Lloyd Wright.
Correct. He was known as Old Blue Eyes.
Frank Sinatra.
Correct. He created eclectic music with his band, the Mothers of Invention.
Frank Zappa.
15 out of 15. They like that one a little bit better. Here we go. Paper and pencil in front of you once again. Evaluate the quantity negative 2 times 2 minus x plus 8 when x is equal to 1/2. Adam of Keene.
Negative
4.5. Plymouth. Alexander.
3.5.
It is 7. In 1903, C.M. Coolidge was commissioned by the advertising firm Brown and Bigelow to create this now iconic series of 16 paintings of canine card sharps. Those paintings were called Dogs Playing Poker. In 1649, this English monarch was executed for high treason. Sophia of Plymouth.
James the First.
King. It was Charles I. Let's try this one. On January 3rd, 1777, George Washington defeated the British in the Battle of Princeton. Who led the British forces? Adam of Keene.
Cornwallis.
Cornwallis is right for the 10 points. So back to Keene we go. We have Shake, Rattle, and Roll. We have Hit the Bricks, and we have Flower Power. Shake, yes, Rattle, and Roll, Hit the Bricks, Flower Power.
Flower Power, you want to ask it? Flower Power, please.
Let's go with the Flower Power. The answers to the following will be a type of flower. Type of flowers that put Dorothy, the Tin Man, the Scarecrow, and the Cowardly Lion to sleep.
Poppies.
Correct. Mountain flower, Captain Von Trapp sings about in The Sound of Music.
Edelweiss.
Correct. Type of flower the Queen of Hearts has painted in Alice in Wonderland.
Roses?
Yes. 15 out of 15 on the bonus. And there's the sound ending our round. Well, Keene High School took a little bit of advantage there in the bonus round to open up a lead halfway through the game, 165 to 90. But we've got the 62nd round coming up right around the corner. Before we get there, though, here's Lori once again, this time talking with the coach from Plymouth High School.
Thanks, Jim. We're here with our returning champions. We're so happy to have them here. Plymouth, and this is Coach Jay Fogarty. You have done an amazing job with these kids.
Thank you. They're a good group of kids, so it's easy to do.
Well, now what do you think has made the team so successful?
We have an incredibly supportive environment in our high school. The year starts out in a couple months. We'll have a preliminary. We have the entire school is welcome to go against our current team. So that's kind of how we recruit. And then as the year progresses, our faculty has a team, and we play faculty versus our Granite State Challenge team, and that's always really fun. We've had a mixed record. Sometimes the faculty wins, so that's a good thing. And last year, our matches, sometimes the principal came and even our superintendent. So people are really behind us, and it's just a really good feeling to have that kind of support.
And then you went all the way down to the championship down in Boston with the winners of Massachusetts.
Yeah, we went to WGBH last year, and that was a total thrill. So,
and now, see, this year I think that the advantage would be on our side because we're having the finals here.
You think home court advantage? All right. Well, we'll have to wait and see.
Well, we're getting close. We're getting close. So I think that we'll have to get back to the match now, see what is going on, and we'll turn things back over to you, Jim.
All right, Lori, and thank you to Jay as well. You look at the Plymouth team that'll be ready to participate here in round number 3. It is our 62nd round. We ask each team 10 questions in 1 minute. We give them 10 points for every correct answer. Bonus them 10 should they get all correct in under a minute. So, Plymouth, you do trail, so let's go over to you, Sophia, and you can talk to everybody and choose from around the world in New Hampshire. Who'll stop the rain? Duck. Around the world in New Hampshire, who'll stop the rain? Duck. Sophia?
Duck, please.
Let's go with duck. And again, Sophia, you can talk to everybody. You got your alternates up there, too. Following answers will all contain the word duck. Start the clock. Reality show about the Robertson family.
Duck Dynasty.
Correct. Disney Duck with nephews Huey, Dewey, and Louie.
Donald Duck.
Correct. Direction students were given in the 50s and 60s in the event of a nuclear attack.
Duck and cover.
Duck and cover.
Correct. An elected official near the end of his or her term.
Lame duck.
Correct. Childhood chasing game.
Duck Goose.
Duck Duck Goose.
Correct. Ernie's favorite bath toy.
Rubber ducky.
Correct. This Looney Tune duck first appeared in Porky's Duck Hunt in 1937.
Daffy Duck.
Correct. A variation of 10-pin bowling, especially popular in Maryland.
Duck bowling?
It is duck pin bowling. New England sports champions ride on these.
Duck boats.
Correct. And he grew up to be a swan.
The ugly duckling.
That is correct. 9 out of 10 on their 62nd round. Well done for Plymouth. 90 points onto the board. Let's go over to Keene and offer them around the world in New Hampshire, or who'll stop the rain?
Who'll stop the rain, please,
who'll
Jim?
Who'll stop the rain? And Adam, you can talk to everybody, including your alternates up there. Identify the following songs related to rain. Songs related to rain. Start the clock. Rihanna's song about what you might carry in the rain.
Umbrella.
Correct. Prince song about colorful precipitation.
Purple Rain.
Correct. James Taylor said he'd seen lonely times when he could not find a friend in this song.
Fire and Rain.
Correct. The Weather Girl sang Hallelujah in this song about an unusual hominid rain.
It's Raining Men.
Correct. The Red Sox play this Milli Vanilli song during rain delays.
Pass.
In this Carpenters song, this combination gets them down, leading them to frown.
Rain and snow.
Rainy days and Mondays. Guns N' Roses power ballad about fall precipitation.
November rain.
Correct. Gene Kelly danced his way through this song.
Singing in the rain.
Correct. Bob Dylan song that asked the question, where have you been, my blue-eyed son?
Pass.
And childhood song about a drain climbing arachnid.
The Itsy Bitsy Spider.
You got it. Judges. 7 out of 10 on there. 62nd round, so 70 points onto the scoreboard for Keene High School. Things tightened up just a little bit there, but still a good lead for Keene as we head into the home stretch by a score of 235 to 180. A couple of reminders now that we have no more talking the rest of the way on these toss-ups, and that if you should answer a question incorrectly, 10 points will be deducted from your team's score. Here we go. This president formed the Space Task Force that led to the development of the space, Sophia of Plymouth.
John F. Kennedy.
I can repeat it for Keene. This president formed the Space Task Force that led to the development of the Space Shuttle program. And it was President Nixon. He was the lead guitarist of the Beatles and wrote While Adam of Keene.
George Harrison.
George Harrison is correct. This playwright is best known for his work, Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf? The playwright is Edward Albee. The perimeter of an 8-foot by 20-foot rectangle will be equal to the perimeter of a square with which side length? The perimeter of an 8-foot by 20-foot rectangle will be equal to the perimeter of a square with which side length? Oscar of Keene.
9.
Plymouth. Andrew.
14.
14 is right for your 10 points. What author devised the three laws of robotics? A robot may not harm a human. Oscar of Keene.
Isaac Asimov.
Isaac Asimov is correct for your 10 points. This novel by William Faulkner tells the story over a 30-year period of the Compson family of Jefferson, Mississippi, and takes its name from a line in Macbeth's final soliloquy that begins, Sophia of Plymouth.
Absalom, Absalom.
To repeat for Keene, this novel by William Faulkner tells the story over a 30-year period of the Compson family of Jefferson, Mississippi, takes its name from a line in Macbeth's final soliloquy that begins, it is a tale told by an idiot. The novel is The Sound and the Fury. Ivan IV, who was Tsar of Russia from 1547 to 1584, is more commonly known, Alexander of Plymouth.
Ivan the Terrible.
Ivan the Terrible is right. The Shard, an 87-story skyscraper, is the tallest building in the European Union. Adam of Keene.
London.
In what city is it located? London is the correct answer. On February 22, 1980, at the Lake Placid Winter Olympics, the U.S. men's hockey team beat the Soviet Union by a score of 4-3, Alexander of Plymouth.
The Miracle on Ice.
In a game that would become known as this, the Miracle on Ice. Well done. 2 minutes to play. The point where the cold waters of the Labrador Current meet the warm waters of this current at the Grand Banks is one of the richest fishing grounds in the world, Adam of Keene.
Gulf Stream.
Gulf Stream is right. On April 25th, 1898, the United States declared war on this country, Adam of Keene.
Spain.
Spain, after the sinking of the battleship Maine in Havana Harbor. This 1848 treaty ended the Mexican-American War. Adam of Keene.
The Treaty of Guadalupe Hidalgo.
You got it for another 10 points. Scottish sailor Alexander Selkirk, who was shipwrecked on an island in the South Pacific for over 4 years, was the inspiration for this book by Daniel Defoe, Sophia of
Robinson Clint. Crusoe.
Robinson Crusoe is right. Which part of the eye bends light rays inward? Sophia of Plymouth?
The lens.
The lens is right for another 10 points and 1 minute to go in our game. This bluegrass musician, who was known for his three-finger banjo picking style, is considered by many to have been the greatest banjo player of all time. His name is Earl Scruggs. This American author is known for the USA Trilogy, a trio of books published in the 1930s. Sophia of Plymouth?
Henry James.
To repeat Peter for Keene. This American author is known for the USA Trilogy, a trio of books published in the 1930s that included the novels The 42nd Parallel, 1919, and The Big Money. His name was John Dos Passos. He was General Secretary of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union from 1985 until its dissolution in 1991. Alexander of Plymouth.
Gorbachev.
Gorbachev is correct. The Union of Concerned Scientists says thermal expansion has raised this 4 to 10. Adam of Keene.
Sea level.
Sea level is right. Another 10 points for Keene as we end the game with a high-scoring game for both teams, but it will be Keene High School moving on into our semifinal round in a very well-played game tonight, 295 to 210. So congratulations to both schools, Keene, for your two wins, and for Plymouth for your previous win and coming back as defending champions from a year ago. Now we're ready for our first semifinal round game. It comes up in about a week or so as the Eagles of Portsmouth Christian Academy will take on the Cardinals of Bishop Gurton High School. That's coming up next here on Granite State Challenge. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.
Major funding for the production of Granite State Challenge has been provided by Unitil, Energy for Life, NEA New Hampshire, shaping the future one student at a time, with additional funding from Heinemann Publishing, D.F. Richard, Markham Image, Tax World Funds, and from viewers like you. Thank you.